Welcome everyone to Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux. This is level 18 of 18, which means we are on the final level of this dungeon. I went on ahead and rested before I saved just to get this out of the way so I won't have to do this again if, knock on wood, I end up dying on this level. It's quite possible. I have no idea what to expect. And since I knew I couldn't end the series without playing a little Final Fantasy music, please enjoy the soundtrack to Final Fantasy VI. It's a heck of a soundtrack. So I looked up the Fooze items, like the chain armor of Fooze, and if you do have the full set, which is the armor, the helmet, the mace, and the holy symbol, it grants you resistance to fire. But I don't have the holy symbol of Fooze, I have the High Priest Myrrh's holy symbol. And it looks like it might be the same set because of the green color, but it's not, unfortunately. And even if it was, fire resistance probably wouldn't be worth it. If I did have the holy symbol of Fooze, then I would have one additional spell per level, which is pretty nice. And I think the armor, or the mace, if you get it says if you get a good hit with mace, then it restores some of your health. Which, I'm not sure I was getting any good hits with a mace, so I probably don't have to worry about it. Let's go ahead and save again now that I recast all of my buffs. So let's see, I'm going to have to end up dropping a whole bunch of crap so I can pick up. I'm positive all of these are going to be keys, you know. Alright, I'm not going to use this. I'm not going to use these. As much as I'd like to use the fancy named items, just not worth it. Gauntlets of Ogre Power, I mean, I might use those for something. Conceivably. Probably not, though. Most of these scrolls I'm probably not going to use whole person. I don't even cast that. Protection from gas, you never know, there might be a gas trap on this level somewhere. Hero's Feast, I'm just going to use that. Why not? Slay Living. That might actually be useful, since if that theory is correct, I might have a better chance of hitting with the scroll than with the actual spell. Protection from Poison, yeah, let's go ahead and use it. Why not? Might as well use all this stuff now. Potion of Speed, sure, why not? Moving much faster. I have two Wands of Fire, and a Wand of Magic Missiles, and a Wand of Paralyzation. I'm not going to use this club. I don't even know why I had that club. Tangerine Potion. Drink up. Left a dry taste in my mouth. I believe that's a Potion of Water Breathing. Potion of Confusion. I'll hang on to that. Wand of Frost. Another Wand of Paralyzation. Wand of Jeez, I have all these wands and I'm not using any of them. Kind of sad, you know. I want to save all these wands until, you know, I'm in a dire situation, but I'm on the last level and I haven't used any of them yet. I don't think there's going to be that dire a situation on this level. Let's detect us up some monsters. There's quite a few, as I might have predicted. I wonder if those stay there. Nope. That was our only glimpse of all the monsters on this level. Cleric Scroll Bless? Why not? I mean, it doesn't stack with my prayer, but what the heck? Protection from cold? Sure. Double Bless? Why not? Oh, I guess that's why not. It doesn't work. Free action? Sure. Slay Living? Hang on to that. Protection from gas? Hang on to that. Protection from evil? You know, I don't like evil. I want to be protected. Protection from level drain? Sure. Negative plane protection. Firestorm. I hang on to that. Detect magic. Okay. Protection from magic. You know that one ion stone that seemed to be protecting me from magic missile might have been protection from magic. Okay. Khaki potion. Feels cooler around here all of a sudden. I believe that's protection from fire. have another potion to speed for when this one wears out. Oil of fiery burning. I'll have to remember to throw that at someone. Alright, let's save again. Oops. Not over that save. Over that save. Now that I'm Superman. Make absolutely sure I don't want to take any of this stuff with me. Doesn't look like it. Okay. So, that's a key. That's a key. Ettins again? Really? Come on, it's the last level? And you pull out Ettins? I mean, I know they make one of the creepiest noises in the game, but... come on. An illusionary wall on my right. Oh, I guess I'd never cast True Seeing again. It's a good point, game. Thank you for reminding me. There we go. Man, I hope the other monster on this level is more impressive than Ettins. Hopefully it didn't double roll Ettins. I mean, sure, it can hit for 22 points of damage, which is kind of rough, but... I mean, give me, like, a Mind Flayer or a Death Knight or something really scary. You know, something that's going to make my heart beat a little faster. And it's a scorpion monster. Well, here's hoping the boss is something impressive. I mean, I understand randomization, but... I mean, I think I've said this in a previous video, they could have... You know, they could have made it so the game goes, hey, this is the last level. Let's pull from this pool of incredibly terrifying monsters. Or, you know, mix it up. Give me more than two monsters on this level. Make me have to deal with Ettins and scorpion monsters and Medusas. And who knows what else. Or give me a beholder. Wow, that would be fun. It might pull out something special for the last boss. I'm really not sure. As I mentioned, I don't actually know if I've actually beaten this game. I thought I have, but now that I think of it, I don't know. I don't really remember what the last boss or the last encounter or whatever entails. Like, I sort of have a vague notion, but it's possible that was just like an assumption that I had when I was a kid, and I am misremembering having an assumption for actually verifying the assumption. So I suppose we'll find out. Oh, great. Okay. I was worried there would be a locked door in that dark area, and I would have to fumble around and figure out what key goes there, but it was just a door. It's a button we haven't seen much of in the course of this game. You know, I bet these things poison you if they can actually hit you. I mean, it would make sense. So I do still have a neutralized poison spell at the ready in case that happens. And I use that protection from poison scroll on myself as well, so I have like double protection going on. You know, now that I think about it, maybe that's not such a creepy noise. Maybe it just seemed creepy because it was unexpected. Okay, well, that's all for this section, unless there's a secret passage straight ahead. Okay. Oh, I see. Man, love that perception. Come on, at least give me something new in the journal. Oh, yeah, that's right. Trolls can regenerate. I forgot about that. I guess that's why they were so tough. Or why they took 1.5 billion hits to kill. Is that really all that's down here? Is there any secret way through here? No, I guess not. I wonder if it identifies your items when you win the game. Probably not, since it doesn't identify them when you die. Like Rogue or NetHack does. Oh, yeah, illusionary wall right here. So I'm going to either win the game or go to my grave never knowing what these ion stones do. Never knowing what... I guess I know what all my rings do. Boy, this ring of feather falling is really coming handy, let me tell you. Not knowing what these amulets do. That's the other thing I haven't identified yet. I was kind of hoping I would find another mirror before the LP was over, but I guess not. Dang it! I still don't understand why the teleporter wants to fling you out facing the wrong direction. The thing behind me. Not very nice. I'm going to pop a coin in here so I don't have to use any magic just yet. Alright, so there's some way to go that I've missed. It's just a matter of... Oh wait, I haven't been down this way yet. Excellent. I am in the right location. Oh, I'll never make it through here. You can tell that, like, the developers of this game just, like, all got together in a room with a microphone and just said, hey, make it sound like we're having a dumb conversation. When they needed to make the sound effect for the Etten. My protection spell has expired. Which one? I had protection from evil, protection from fire, protection from poison. Protection from keys. You know, I sure hope this music isn't too loud. I didn't double check it before I started, but I figured it wouldn't be any louder than the last music I had queued up, so I figured it would be fine. I screwed up the volume on this last video, then I might have to re-record it. That would be a bummer. Diamond. Somehow, I have the feeling that's the bad kind of diamond, not the kind of diamond that I can take out of the dungeon and sell for well above its normal market value. Magic plate mail. Not better than what I have. That's this thing, right? Yes, you can tell because its color is similar to the color of these dragon things. It has the same weird marble pattern on it. Rations? I'll eat those. Aw, all of my scrolls and other buffs are already starting to wear off. That's a bummer. I guess I don't have this key yet. The key of faith. Nope. Gotta go looking around for that one. Okay, well, where to now then? Oh, I have not been down this hallway yet. Huh. That's the first time I've seen this lock, I believe. Kind of interesting that I haven't seen that once at any point during this LP. Until now. That's what the game's been saving for the end game. But yeah, we've already fought all these monsters before. But don't worry. We have a bunch of awesome new locks. Or actually just that one. But it was pretty awesome, trust me. I don't even really know what I'm looking at. Looks like a baby chick with a blue beak. Looks like two of them with a red thing in the middle and weird pattern surrounding them. I don't know. Key of Faith. You know, if it was really a key of faith, or if it was really a lock of faith, I wouldn't even need a key. I would just pray to God to open the door for me. That's the real key of faith, isn't it? But don't worry. I have faith that whatever D&D god I worship will unlock this door for me. Boy, these Ettins can't even hit me anymore. Barely. Hit me a couple times, but they don't pack nearly as much punch as they used to. Leather boots. Wow. That's a good find for level 18 of the dungeon. Non-magical leather boots. Let me tell ya. I mean, honestly, I don't really know what I want. I mean, I have everything I could ask for at this point. I mean, I don't really need a weapon since my hammers are more than enough. I have a minus 6 armor class, which is pretty dang good. So really, I don't know what other treasure I would want to ask for. Hey, there's a cursed ring. I think I'll just leave that alone. Boy, there's plenty of these things. I'll give it that. It is sure throwing a crap load of Ettins at me. Maybe that's the last level difficulty spike. It just multiplies the number of monsters you have to fight by 3. Whoa! Oh god. Okay, that thing actually is kind of scary. Okay, what was that? Use my wand of curing. Looks like some sort of dragon. Use all the charges, really? Oh, here. Have a wand of curing. Merry Christmas. I have another one of those, right? Wand of fire. Protection from gas. Wand of curing. Here we go. Alright, let's use some of these wands on this thing. This might be... might be the big... the BBG, as we say in Dungeons & Dragons, or the big bad guy. Wait. I thought I equipped the wand of frost. There we go. Hey! I'm trying to kill a dragon, dude. Way cramping my style. I don't know what kind of dragon that is. Ouch! Kind of dragon that hurts quite a bit, apparently. Alright, let's not be cornered by this guy. What do you say? I forget where my other hammer went. Okay. Holy symbol, what did I do with it? There we go. Alright, hopefully that thing lost interest and it's not tracking me down this hallway. Now the only dragon I remember seeing in the manual was actually a frost dragon. I'm not sure if this game has other types of dragons. Let's try one to fire. Fire against frost. Okay, so none of that worked. I guess let's just try beating it down with my two hammers. I'm not really... It's usually... Well, no, a potion of invisibility will wear off as soon as I, as soon as I attack, so... Well, I am sped up, so let's take advantage of my speed here and throw multiple hammers at this thing. I couldn't read the whole message. It said, I've bested the final monster and the orb. Something. I'm gonna have to go back and look at the video on that one. But there we go. Duke of the Bump, 1 on 18. With almost 4 times as many experience points as the next highest contender for the high score list. This has been Let's Play Dungeon Hack. Redux. Thanks everyone for watching. Thanks to Kostya for supporting me with the donation. I hope the LP was worth it. I hope everyone enjoyed watching. I guess I'm going to take a Wario break and jump into Wario Land tomorrow, which should be very interesting. It'll be my first experience with that game. And then after a quick break, I will jump into the next donation game, which is Super House of Dead Ninjas, which is like an action roguelike platformer that I'm looking forward to trying out because I've never played it before. Oh wait, I guess we do get a cutscene. Hold on. Where did he find that wheelbarrow?
My thanks, adventurer.
You're welcome.
Now come, it is time for us to leave.
Okay, you can just magic us out of here again, right? Like, WTF? Can't you teleport me out of here so I don't have to cart this huge pile of treasure back to town? I mean, honestly, that looks way too heavy for him to cart around like that, even with a wheelbarrow. You know, I don't think I ever actually finished this game, even on easy, because I do not remember this cutscene. I remember the ending of this game. Well, I guess I don't remember. I misremembered the end of this game not having anything to do with the intro. So I must have dreamed it. Thanks, Dreamforge. This game. John McGurk, Coach McGurk, supported development on this game. Huh. This game had a lot of flaws. Not going to mince words. It is not well balanced for any kind of character other than a cleric. Well, I mean, it's not well balanced for a cleric either. It's too easy with the cleric and too difficult with any other character class. I guess I could turn some of the difficulty options up, play with the cleric that way, and have a little bit more of a tough time, but I'm not really sure how fun that would be, since all that would do is make the monster take 10 times longer to kill and throw a bunch more annoying things at you. More pits and traps and areas where you can't use magic and water levels. I don't even want to imagine what a water level's like. But, you know, despite all the flaws, I still had fun going through. I guess it could have been worse. I mean, a few of those levels were genuinely challenging, mostly because of...
Hey, I am leaving! The adventure is over!
Okay.
Look at all this treasure! My adventure has just begun!
Indeed it has. I was going to say, hey, you dropped something there, buddy, but you went back for it. The end. Alright, well, thanks everyone for watching. Let's play Super Wario Land Begins Tomorrow. And /. You can see my Simpsons playlist there. I wasn't expecting it to just abruptly end like that. I thought it would take me back to the main menu. Ah, well. See you guys tomorrow.